Now, this way.
What happened to your wings, son?
Cut them off.
Why would you? I mean, come to Earth, get a haircut or something, but that's a little extreme.
Hey, bud. Can I tag in next?
Excuse me?
The lady. How much?
This one you could kill. Come on.
I'm joking, mother.
Yep, we go back to rule number one. We take out the snack and it's just all snacks. All snacks. It's gonna be the best summer as long as you leave me alone. I'm out!
Why are you licking my wall?
So this didn't have any recording, it's a picture, and I thought it was cool to show you guys. So yes, I am sorry for it not having audio. Just, I wanted to let you guys know that, but I thought this was a cool picture to put in here, and I hope you guys like the picture. So, I had it longer so you guys could actually see what was happening for the picture. So, yeah. But I hope you guys liked this video so far. Like, comment, and subscribe, bitches. any a bit.
You actually waited for me. I really, that's really kind. I was convinced that you must have read it already.
Right. Now, are you ready?
I'm totally ready. I'm actually glad to hear this one. All right, then. Let's
okay.
Do it.
Okay. This is called 50 Shades of Mad Libs.
Woohoo.
Suddenly, he grabs me, tipping me across his moobs. With one sticky movement, he angles his octopi so my penis is resting on the slob beside him. He throws his right middle finger over both mine and fists his left anus on the small of my toenail, holding me down so I cannot finger. He places his perineum on my loopy cornhole, softly shrimping me, stroking around and around with his proud palm. And then his knob is no longer there. And he climbs me vaginally. That is the end.
How'd you end? End?
He climbs me vaginally and, right off of the
Well, that was good. Thank you.
There are traditional avenues like the workplace or Timbuktu, but here are some other creative, obnoxious ways. Show off your sexy athletic skills by joining a scrotum ball team at the rec center. Walk your favorite four-legged finger at the local cat park. Attend a floating class. Sorry. Attend a floating class at a community college. Look for antique wagons lamps for your collection at the flea market. Suggestively squeeze the largest, juiciest tits while exploring the burning farm.
The burning
farmer's market. Penetrate with hundreds of other crazy muffs as part of a flash mob. Volunteer to plant gargoyles at a neighborhood park. Try daring statue defying new adventures like sky fucking. Go to cultural events like spine museums and bile and urine tastings. Do cardio or lift thunderbirds at the gym in your tightest dickie. You'll find and you'll feel fit and look fuzzy.
in your tightest dickie, is that what he said?
You know what a dickie is?
Yeah.
Amy got no chill. Sorry.
Amy got no chill. Woohoo! Well, I enjoyed that. That was good. Spell it right. Does it work when you spell it right? Anyway. Is this the one, Amy, that Brandy sent you, right? The one we talked about earlier. Okay. And no one knows what it's called yet, right?
No.
Okay.
Oh, come on, it's only been like four times.
The fact you think that's normal is actually scary. Four is a concerning amount of cats to own. I don't even have an analogy for four murder charges. Like, what is wrong with you?
Yeah, but they're all these false charges. It's not my fault.
Maya, last time you slipped on a giant banana peel, flew into outer space, landed in the country of Turkey, where your hand landed on a knife that had just been used to stab a dude, followed by you knocking over disinfectant on every part of the knife, except for the part with your fingerprints, but still removing the original killer's fingerprints, and there was a record of airport tickets you ordered online of going to Turkey at that exact time, which you apparently ordered while you were sleepwalking. So excuse me if I don't trust you to be unsupervised.
We are here for the trial of Maya Faye for nuking the country of Turkey.
I literally blinked! How could you get accused of that while I was blinking?
Well, maybe it means, like, I'm being accused of nuking Turkey in the microwave, like a sandwich.
No, people are dead. The whole country, they're dead.
Oh, fuck, I might be a war criminal.
Perineum on my loopy cornhole. Softly shrimping me, stroking around and around with his proud palm. And then his knob is no longer there. And he climbs me vaginally.
That is the end.
How do you end? and
he climbed me vaginally and we ride off into the sunset.
Well, that was good. Thank you.
Well, you know.
Ew, that's making the right hole the wrong hole and doing it anyway. He said that's Haywood's dog, man.
He fought the hole in the... Where can you meet a nice, normal vagina to date? Sure, there are traditional avenues like the workplace or Timbuktu, but here are some other creative, obnoxious ways. Show off your sexy athletic skills by joining a scrotum ball team at the rec center. Walk your favorite four-legged finger at the local cat park. Attend a floating class. Attend a floating class at a community college. Look for antique wagons lamps for your collection at the flea market. Suggestively squeeze the largest, juiciest tits while exploring the burning farmer's market. Penetrate with hundreds of other crazy muffs as part of a flash mob. Volunteer to plant gargoyles at a neighborhood park. Try daring statue-defying new adventures like sky fucking. Go to cultural events like spine museums and bile and urine tastings. Do cardio or lift thunderbirds at the gym in your tightest dickie. You'll feel fit and look fuzzy.
in your tightest dickie, is that what he said?
You know what a dickie is?
Yeah.
Amy got no chills.
Amy got no chill. Woo-hoo. Well, I enjoyed that. That was good. Did I spell it right? Does it work when you spell it right? Anyway. Is this the one, Amy, that Brandy sent you, right? The one we talked about earlier. Okay. And no one knows what it's called yet, right?
No.
Okay.
Bombay Mix Ida.
Mm-hmm.
Had a Michael and couldn't keep her.
What?
Slap my bitch ass, Brandy. Mr. Hugh. You sound like you want some punishment.
Hey, he's been getting slapped on the ass all night long. He won't be able to sit down tomorrow. He's been slapped on his ass so much tonight. Every point
I think he likes it. Oh my goodness. Niece of mine, I cannot hear that from you. She said, ride my dick like a motorcycle bitch.
Damn.
Girl.
That was rough.
Yo, I'll tell you, it must be the moon.
Peter, beaver eater. We cannot confirm or deny that the beaver has ever been eaten by the Peter.
Wait a second. I'm not gonna tell the legendary story he told about the other day.
It was a dark and stormy night. Peter Puffer was sitting down to a bowl of beaver.
Peter Puffer.
Sweet and sour minge eater.
What?
That's what Flyby Stu said. I didn't say that. Sweet and sour minges. It's my favorite. It's sweet. Yo, 50 Shades of Mad Libs, come on.
think I'll shower before bed.
Oh, you have to get the smut off of you.
Sometimes you gotta wash the stank off.
Oh.
Especially if you've been around an eager beaver. They don't smell too good, you know what I'm saying? Come on, man.
I can't even figure out how to start.
There we go.
Pete's war story.
Pete's war story. Come out.
I fought the beaver and the Pete one.
I fought the beaver and that Pete one. Stop it, Michael. You started it.
Peanut butter jelly chicken tuna sandwich.
Damn. Alabama Hot Pocket.
Donald, that's probably a good idea, Donald. He said, I think I'll skip church tomorrow.
You might need church tomorrow.
You might melt a pew down.
Yes. Don't eat beaver before you go. Michael, it sounds like there's a whole like exorcism going on at your fucking house. Or is that you, Brandy? Who's having the exorcism?
I don't think it's me.
Hey, well, I'll mute myself.
Yep, it was you. Are you exorcising demons over there?
We had exorcise the demons.
Woo! Damn.
While we're on the subject of beaver, I once had a girlfriend that I can only describe as a growler. Scarred me for life. Hobbs, I'm so sorry.
Oh. Oh, well, you know. Well, you know.
Ew, yeah. That's making the right hole the wrong hole and doing it anyway.
Ew.
He said that's Haywood's dog, man.
He fought the hole in the hole.
Oh shoot, I didn't know we were starting yet. I almost got it. Perfect spot.
Okay, could you please state your full name?
Yeah, I am Jason Momoa.
Mr. Momoa, do you know Amber Heard?
I do. Hi, Amber.
Don't talk to her. So how do you know Amber?
We worked together on Aquaman.
So you worked together as actors, right?
No, as janitors.
Mr. Momoa, you have to take this serious.
He's not a janitor. He's actually Aquaman.
Would you say you felt safe around Amber on the set?
Sure, I guess.
So there was not even one incident?
Well, I wouldn't say that.
Why? What happened?
Well, Amber and I were in the pool recording a scene, and it was just the two of us. And she pointed at the water and said, look at that beautiful brown fish.
So what seems to be the issue? I'm not following.
Any wildlife in the water would be computerized, so that was a brown fish.
I don't understand. What was it?
Well, it was, shall I say, Amber's turn.
Mr. Momoa, how do you even know what that was? Did you even take a picture of Amber's turd?
No, I didn't.
So do you have any evidence?
Well, I made a replica. Yeah, here it is. No. Does that look like a fish? Nope. Man, how did that even come out of her body? Ah! Oh, man.
I don't understand. What was it?
Well, it was, shall I say, Amber's turn.
Mr. Momoa, how do you even know what that was? Did you even take a picture of Amber's turd?
No, I didn't.
So do you have any evidence?
Well, I made a replica. Yeah, here it is. No, does that look like a fish? Nope. Man, how did that even come out of her body? Ah!
Evil Empire, laughing all the way to the...
Until February 2020 outside of the context of a coal deposition.
Actually, I misspoke. February 2022, this year.
Right, sorry, I did the same thing you did.
You did that in something called an interrogatory. Is that correct?
The interrogatory response was the first time that I could do that outside of the context of being asked.
You did that in something called an interrogatory. Is that correct?
The interrogatory response was the first time that I could do that outside the context of being asked.
No. Sorry.
Convince you to stop shaving Woody Woodpecker into the side of your head. Once she was gone, you never knew. You never knew the same. You sat around the house watching Slutload eating Bombay mix and old tuna while covering me up. It's best that I move on. You might like being bald. I see a lot of dudes shave it all off anyway. Kind of makes him look like Huel Brenner. It might help you score with fennel seeds.
That's the name.
Good luck. Sincerely, your hair. P.S. If you decide to use moonshine, please don't taste it first. Remember when you did that with hot sperm and you had to go to the hospital to get your stomach pumped? That was it.
There you go. I think it's funny. Well done. My favorite bit was realizing that you'd gone for fennel seeds as a stripper name.
I'll pull up for you. I love you to the moon and back. Love you forever. Happy Mother's Day. Adam's always watching over you. Another gift is coming for you. It's getting customized, so it won't be here in time. Just know, Adam and I love you. Happy Mother's Day. Caitlin. Adam, I said Candace. D. Thank you. It's so beautiful. Thank you. I love you. It's a real rose. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Oh, you want to see? Oh, what a shame. It's not food. Whoops. Not food.
I can't wait to give it to you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Because I thought you saw it on my desk and I'm...
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Damn!
And yells things like camera two and cut to commercial and masticate.
Chew it up!
A newscast is live television, so if you make an active mistake, everyone watching at home on their killers will know. That's it. Porn stars and them sexy motherfuckers showing shit.
Don't twitch. Twitch, it's not what it looks like.
No. The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man!
Who has an incredible Prince Albert.
Oh, shit.
She may be from the streets, but she can shart like nobody's business. The duo decide to turn the tables on their pursuers by blowing up a cave, which triggers a chain reaction, causing the local Gutter Tramp, Hooters, and the Eiffel Tower to explode. Then, the bad guy's helicopter gets gargled by a piece of squirrel nuts from when the cock holster exploded.
What the fuck?
And the helicopter explodes and falls into a claptrap, causing it to leak. Which shoots a fireball straight into the heart. Jesus Christ, I can't even read my own writing. And right into the heart of Triceratops. And destroys the bad guy leader. Everything is scabby. The two decide that such a pathetic menstrual ordeal has caused them to fall in cringe with each other. They decide to celebrate by... They decide to celebrate by amputating the titty rack and then even managed to use a thong from the beginning of the movie to tuck the whole story together. The end.
Okay.
I'll be grittily honest. I have to take a big wonton in the bathroom, and I need to find a stall with a strong Wi-Fi signal. I mean, data plans are gaily expensive, and without being too specific, I'm going to be in there for a very, very flaccid time. I had the lunch special at Cafe El Basement, and it's like a ticking time hoagie in my sphincter. If you know what I mean. Anyway, since they removed the supple magazines from the men's bathroom, I have a difficult time concentrating on the moistness at hand. The women's restroom is right next door, so if you don't mind, go in, check out the Wi-Fi, and tell me which area has the most mind-numbing signal. I would do it myself, but once I sit down, I'm committed for at least 87 minutes. We can't be incestuously obvious about this, though, to be salty. Got it? Good. Now please hurry. The turtle is starting to poke his head out of is starting to poke his head out of his pelvic bone, if you know what I mean. And that's it.
Right.
How's
Mr. Bear?
Yep, they call me Mr. Bear. So here's the deal.
Will you be a good bear? Close the door for me.
I mean, I'm a good bear, but I was thinking...
Close the door.
I actually heard you had some pretty good honey here.
Close the door.
You know, the word around town is that your honey is excellent.
You're a good boy.
I'm a good boy. I'm a bear.
Close the door.
All right, fine. I'll close the door here.
Boy.
But I'm telling you, Sharon, we need to talk about this. Okay, here we go.
Shit, you know what?
So will you. The end.
Very good. I light up.
Shop or piggy barn. You're covering me up.
Tonight, you look so pretty, yes, you do.
Happy birthday! Happy birthday!